we're talking about bringing the discourse down. Joy, you've worn blackface. Whoopi,
no,
you
I
said
have.
That
I'm sorry,
Roman
I'm
Polanski.
Sorry, I'm, not. I'm sorry, and don't.
You,
if
you
do
it. Roman Polanski, it wasn't rape when he raped a child. So let's
okay.
talk about
so, yeah, no, let's
thing.
Talk about this. So you want to bring this up? The yeah. question came up.
I did not go to blackface. Please.
No, she was not in blackface.
Thank you.
Anyone who follows Trump Jr. on Twitter knows that he loves to argue, but I had no idea that he was this good in person. Arguing with left-wingers requires a good memory and the ability to throw their hypocrisy back at them. It's not an easy thing to do when you're on the spot. It's something media leftists aren't used to since they bury all their improprieties while constantly reminding everybody about their oppositions. This is what happened yesterday on The View when Don Jr. inexplicably appeared on the show. When I first saw it, I couldn't believe it. Why would Don Jr. go on a show that's so vapid and unfriendly? And my questions were answered almost immediately.
He also called Mexicans rapists. He made...
He wait a second! He said some coming across the border, and that's a fact.
No,
look at what's going on
I
at the border.
Let her finish. Called Mexicans, some Mexicans rapists.
Quickly, I just want to point out Behar's sleight of hand right there. Notice how she quickly moved on from claiming that Trump called all Mexicans rapists to quickly conceding and moving on that he called some Mexican rapists. That's a huge difference, and it's a great example of how the media perpetuates a lie by repeating it over and over. How can you deny that some of the illegal immigrants coming across the border are criminals and rapists? It's actually an undeniable fact.
Talking about lowering the discourse to his level, which is horrible for this country.
We've all done things that we regret. I mean, if we're talking about bringing the discourse down, Joy, you've worn blackface. Whoopi,
no,
you
I
said
have.
That
I'm sorry,
Roman
I'm
Polanski.
Sorry, I'm sorry, and don't.
You,
if you,
you said
do
that
it.
Roman Polanski, it wasn't rape when he raped a child. So let's
okay.
talk about
so, yeah, no, let's
things.
Talk
Come
about
on,
this. So
fair.
You want to bring this up? The
yeah.
question came up.
I did not
about,
go in blackface, please.
No, she was not in blackface.
Thank you.
Oh my God. Okay, that was one of the most epic shutdowns I've seen in a while. Whoopi and Behar look completely flabbergasted because they're simply not used to people bringing up inconvenient facts like this. It's true, Behar once dressed up like a black person, even though they emphatically deny it. Unfortunately for them, the internet exists, and so is easily accessible footage of Behar admitting that she wore blackface.
29. It was a Halloween party. I went as a beautiful African woman.
Oh, yes, you ain't black.
But that's my hair. That's my hair.
That, you can be, yeah, but it is.
So you have tanning lotion on,
a little. I had makeup that was a little bit darker than my skin.
I did not go in blackface, please.
No, she was not in blackface.
Thank you.
All right, listen, being black, I recognize blackface. This I can say.
Wrong.
In all their screeching, Whoopi managed to move on from the topic that she once minimized Roman Polanski's rape of a child as not rape. It's true, she said it, and she actually caught a lot of flack at the time from Fox News while the other networks just ran cover for her.
Not charged. I know it wasn't rape.
Yeah, there was a statutory rape.
I
child molest, maybe? I'm
I
not
think
sure.
It was something.
Molest.
It was something else, but I don't believe it was rape.
By the way, she's not the only one. Polanski's got a lot of defenders and friends in Hollywood. It really makes you wonder if Hollywood isn't just one big pedo ring, especially given recent events with Epstein and now proof that the media has been covering for him. There are other great examples of hypocrisy from these hyper-partisan simpletons that Don Jr. just didn't bring up, such as the time that Whoopi Goldberg claimed that the Japanese didn't bomb Pearl Harbor. And come to think of it, didn't Whoopi's husband, Tony Danza, also dress up in blackface? Wait, don't tell me. It's different when Democrats do it. The point here is that these two have been saying stupid, outrageous, and hateful things for quite a long time now. They really have no right to complain about lowering the discourse or lecturing others about ill-conceived words. We got to where we are, thanks in large part to The View and other leftist media.
If he's so transparent, why does he...
I don't think I should have to forego my First Amendment rights. I didn't want to create hysteria, but if I'm reading an article, be like, oh, the name's out there. I didn't even realize that this thing's some sort of big sort of secret.
You don't regret doing it.
But Abby, you guys, ABC is right now chasing down a whistleblower about all of the Epstein stuff because those stories were killed. So if we're going to have the conversation about the outrage about whistleblowers, you work with CBS stuff. You work with CBS to out a whistleblower who came up with a story that's a Drudge Report. Like, this is not some secret, but to then say, because it's Donald Trump Jr., because he's an outspoken guy, to then create... Why was there no outrage when...
Listen, this is not a MAGA rally, okay?
I don't know how many people here read the Drudge Report.
Shut up, audience. You can only applaud when we tell you to applaud. And I love how she just dismisses the Drudge Report. Nobody that she knows reads the Drudge Report. A news site that's been in the 10 most visited news sites for the last 20 plus years. Everybody's been talking about this whistleblower and who he is for the past week. However, if you turn on CNN, MSNBC, or even Fox, you're gonna find pundits feigning ignorance, even though we've all known who this guy is for the last week. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell. You probably won't know about new content otherwise. YouTube demonetizes pretty much everything I upload, so if you want to support this channel, please consider subscribing to me on Patreon, Subscribestar, or just sending a donation on PayPal. You can find all the links in the description and the pinned comment. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.